Okay, now let us discuss about the different types of pressures with a graph. So now I am plotting a graph between absolute vacuum and pressure. So at some point, atmospheric pressure will be there. And at absolute vacuum, pressure is zero. There is no pressure present at the absolute vacuum because in the name itself says it is a vacuum. So first of all, we see about the absolute pressure. The pressure measured from absolute vacuum is called as absolute pressure. That means absolute vacuum is this one. If the pressure is measuring from this point, absolute vacuum, then we call it as the absolute pressure. That means the pressure is start from absolute vacuum. This is absolute pressure. Next, gauge pressure. If the pressure is measured using gauge, then it is called as gauge pressure. And it is above the atmospheric pressure. That means gauge pressure. So gauge pressure mainly used whenever we have to find out the pressure using the gauges, then it is called as the gauge pressure. And the gauge pressure value is always above the atmosphere. So we know that in the graph already this is the atmospheric pressure. So if we want to find out the gauge pressure, means the gauge pressure value should lies above the atmospheric pressure. So here gauge pressure will be there. Third one, vacuum pressure. So vacuum, in the name itself says it is a vacuum. That means there is no pressure will be there, and if at all any pressure also present, that is also negative value will be there. So the vacuum pressure is always lies below the atmospheric pressure, and its value is also negative. So here atmospheric pressure will be there. If we want to find out the vacuum pressure, means that vacuum pressure should comes below the atmospheric pressure. That means the direction is this, in this way. This is vacuum pressure. And if you, next one is atmospheric pressure. The pressure surrounding the atmosphere is called atmospheric pressure, and this is the atmospheric pressure. So from this graph we can say that the absolute pressure always starts from the absolute vacuum, and the gauge pressure is always above the atmospheric pressure, and vacuum pressure is always lies below the vacuum pressure. So if we want to find out the total absolute pressure from this graph, we can say that absolute pressure starts from here and it is above the atmospheric pressure. So what is the total value of the absolute pressure? Means it is atmospheric pressure plus gauge pressure. So from this we can say that at absolute pressure, absolute pressure is equal to atmospheric pressure plus gauge pressure. If at all there is no gauge pressure, means then absolute pressure is equal to the atmospheric pressure, and vacuum pressure is always below the atmospheric pressure and its value is negative.